In our Earth Matters series today, what was once in a seemingly endless supply, the Chinook salmon, a critical link in the Pacific food chain, well, they're now endangered in the Pacific Northwest, which has caused officials to cancel the fall fishing season in the Columbia River. And, as CNN's Bill Weir reports, the salmon shortage is causing residents to have to make a very difficult choice.
As much as air or water, so much life in the Pacific Northwest depends on salmon. Over 130 species rely on nature's original food delivery. But fewer salmon are surviving the heroic swim from open ocean to spawning streams hundreds of miles inland. And that means trouble for two creatures that really love the king of fish, killer whales, and us. In your grandparents' day, the Columbia Basin seemed to produce a never-ending supply, and salmon the size of people. But those big June hog Chinooks are extinct now. And this year, numbers were so low, the fall fishing season was canceled.
The estimates are about 17 million salmon would return to the Columbia every year. It was the greatest salmon fishery in the world. And now it's about a million.
And most of those are hatchery fish, with weaker genes and less fat than their wild cousins. So the southern resident killer whales that live on Chinook are starving. There are only 73 of this kind of orca left on the planet. And after a grieving mom pushed her dead calf around Puget Sound for weeks last summer, it rekindled a decades-old debate. Salmon versus dams.
What would you say to folks who say the best thing that could happen for these animals in this ecosystem is to take these dams down?
Yeah. I'd say, you know, for the Army Corps of Engineers, we're looking to do the right thing. We're looking to operate the dams that are here while we're taking a close look at what the future of these dams are in the region.
To find their birth stream, many Chinook coming out of the Pacific must navigate at least 8 dams, 4 on the Columbia, 4 on the Lower Snake. These are the 4 that would likely come down first. But removing a dam takes an act of Congress, and will meet stiff resistance from special interests like wheat farmers who need dams and locks to float their crop to market. And since Bonneville Dam alone can provide carbon-free power to a city the size of Seattle, the debate divides lovers of wildlife on all sides.
I think we're trying to do our best to improve conditions through the migration channel, through the river for the salmon, trying to make sure that power and fish can coexist here in the Columbia Basin.
But 13 species of fish remain threatened or endangered, even though the federal government has spent over $16 billion trying to make dammed rivers more fish-friendly.
Yes, the salmon can cross the fish ladders, but the river, the Columbia River, is too hot. The reservoirs behind the dams have caused this hot water problem because they're stagnant, absorbing a lot of solar radiation.
I see.
And then couple that with climate change, and climate change is pushing that over the edge to make the river too warm for salmon to survive.
And it's not just the rivers. Scientists are worried that the infamous blob of warm water off the Washington-Oregon coast is back.
So we're kind of wondering, wow, is this happening again? And it's kind of alarming because it's so close on the heels of that past event.
Dams have long been concrete symbols of human ingenuity. But now, with entire ecosystems in hot water, how much longer can they stand?
Jay Inslee, the governor of Washington's, arguably the greenest governor in America, is being very careful on this issue, Jake. He's appointed a task force to study the killer whale decline, but it's just a little sample of when it takes 100 years to break the planet, putting it back together is really, really complicated.
All right, another excellent report from Bill Weir. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.